LRD power control with pressure cutoff. The pressure cutoff corresponds to a pressure control which adjusts the pump displacement back to VG min, when the pressure setting is reached. This function overrides the power control, i.e. below the preset pressure value, the power function is effective. The pressure cutoff function is integrated into the pump control module and is preset to a specified value at the factory. Setting range from 50 to 350 bar. LRE power control with pressure cutoff, 2-stage. By connecting an external pilot pressure to port Y, the basic value of the pressure cutoff can be increased by 50 plus 20 bar and a second pressure setting implemented. This value is usually above the primary pressure relief valve setting and therefore disables the pressure cutoff function. The pressure signal at port Y must be between 20 and 50 bar. LR. Power control with stroke limiter. The stroke limiter can be used to vary or limit the displacement of the pump continuously over the whole control range. The displacement is set in LRH with the pilot pressure PST, maximum 40 bar, applied to port Y or in LRU by the control current applied to the proportional solenoid. A DC current of 12V, U1, or 24V, U2, is required to control the proportional solenoid. The power control overrides the stroke limiter control, i.e. below the hyperbolic power characteristic, the displacement is controlled by the control current or pilot pressure. When exceeding the power characteristic with a set flow or load pressure, the power control overrides and reduces the displacement following the hyperbolic characteristic. To permit operation of the pump displacement control from its starting position VG max to VG min, a minimum control pressure of 30 bar is required for the electric stroke limiter LRU1/2 and the hydraulic stroke limiter LRH2/6. The required control pressure is taken either from the load pressure, or from the externally applied control pressure at the G port. To ensure functioning of the stroke limiter even at low operating pressure, port G must be supplied with external control pressure of approximate 30 bar. Note: if no external control pressure is connected at G, the shuttle valve must be removed. LRH1/5 hydraulic stroke limiter. Negative characteristic. Control from VG max to VG min. With increasing pilot pressure, the pump swivels to a smaller displacement. Start of control, at VG max, can be set from 4 to 10 bar. State start of control in clear text in the order. Starting position without control signal, pilot pressure VG max. Characteristic H1. Increase in pilot pressure, VG max, VG min, delta P equals 25 bar. LRH2/6 hydraulic stroke limiter, positive characteristic. Control from VG min to VG max. With increasing pilot pressure, the pump swivels to a higher displacement. Start of control, at VG min, can be set from 4 to 10 bar. State start of control in clear text in the order. Starting position without control signal, pilot pressure. At operating pressure and external control pressure 30 bar, VG min. Characteristic H2. Increase in pilot pressure, VG min, VG max, dash delta P equals 25 bar. EP, electric control with proportional solenoid. With the electric control with proportional solenoid, the pump displacement is adjusted proportionally to the solenoid current, resulting in a magnetic control force, acting directly onto the control spool that pilots the pump control piston. Control from VG min to VG max. With increasing control current, the pump swivels to a higher displacement. Starting position without control signal, control current. At operating pressure and external control pressure 30 bar, VG min. A control pressure of 30 bar is required to swivel the pump from its starting position VG max to VG min. The required control pressure is taken either from the load pressure, or from the externally applied control pressure at port G. To ensure the control even at low operating pressure 30 bar, the port G must be supplied with an external control pressure of approximate 30 bar.